down to those I call the intellectual efulefus led by Dr. Azikiwe. I've now come to Azikiwe. The same way Ahmadu Bello is the father of modern hate speech in Nigeria is how Nnamdi Azikiwe is the father of Igbo one Nigeria efulefus in our land and beyond. It was Nnamdi Azikiwe that brought betrayal into Eastern political mentality. When you see the likes of your governors today and the likes of Ohanaeze Ndioshi, wardens of this world, when you see them behaving the way they do, when they come out and they say they're going to sabotage Biafra again, their granddaddy is Azikiwe. I've now given you the three names of those that founded Nigeria. Now tell me if you want to live in a house built by these men. They didn't found Nigeria, of course. Lugard did. Three of them. This is the Efulefu. He believes in selling his own people. Anybody celebrating Nnamdi Azikiwe is daft and useless. You are beyond useless. You don't know anything. I'm not a crowd follower. I give you the facts and I defend it. And I shall do so tonight. Nnamdi Azikiwe was a traitor and no intellectual juggernaut has claimed. Rubbish. He's nothing. He was an appeaser and a man dominated by the desire to rule an empire he did not conquer. Look at the breed of traitors that Zeke produced and their children who are today either living in Lagos, Abuja, or in Kano, or elsewhere. They are the most useless traitors and Fulani apologists we have. Who can dispute this very fact? The wickedness and spineless idiocy that characterized Modus Ohanaeze and the present crop of Efulefus in government houses, you know, they call themselves governors, all stem from the politics of treachery of Azikiwe. Don't take my word for it. We are going to hear from Azikiwe himself in his own words, because Nigerians are ahistorical. They lack historical knowledge and wisdom. They are not properly tutored nor educated. And sometimes I think they can best be described as indulging in intellectual banditry and poor reasoning capacity. As you go you buy too much, it's not very good. But I'm just telling you, Zeke of Africa, he was nothing. I want people to now listen to this very man called Zeke and tell me what you make of him. This is your so-called Zeke that they are celebrating somewhere in Anambra State. They say he's a heavyweight. He's a this, he's a that. Zeke is a disgrace. I'm sure he's in hell somewhere. An utter and unmitigated disaster against our people. We are suffering today because of him. And let us hear what he had to say when he went to London. He was running from our people and he traveled to London. I want to hear what he has to say so that people can judge for themselves. So that our people can judge for themselves. The man is something else. Something else. Let us see if we can get him.
On Friday, September 5th,
this is Zeke.
1969, I alighted at the Lagos airport at 2 p.m. And I spent the next 21 days in visiting the capitals of the 12 states of Nigeria, including 4 university towns and certain parts of the liberated areas on Friday, September 5th.
Now, did you hear him?
It has made it clear to me that all of us have now realized the mistakes we made in the past by fighting one another.
This is after the Fulanis must have finished killing our people. This is Nnamdi Azikiwe, where he took money from Shell BP in London talking rubbish against his own people. He is calling our gallant soldiers rebels. Nnamdi Azikiwe. I can't call him Nnamdi, please. I can't. It is a very big shame. Very big shame. Azikiwe. Calling Ojukwu a rebel. Azikiwe. Because Ojukwu did not give. The same thing they are doing today. He wants to be the leader. Anywhere he goes, he wants to rule. He wants to rule. He wants to be number one. Hausa people fully rejected him. He ran down to ask Ojukwu to vacate his office. The same thing he did to Eyoeta. Why did we have enmity before IPOB came? Was it not because of Eyoeta? What this same man did to Eyoeta? Eyoeta was the head of government business in the East. He was sacked. He went to Yoruba people. He was kicked out of Yoruba parliament in Ibadan. He ran back to Enugu and asked Eyoeta to leave. That is why they said that Igbos don't know how to share. It's because of this man, this idiotic Asikiwe. Some of you don't know history. After now, calling you on the online, people who don't know anything. Do you know who is Eyoeta? If you went to UNN, as I did, you know about Eyoeta. Go and go the man. Eyoeta, E-Y-O-I-T-T-A-H, if I'm not mistaken. Or is it I-T-T-A? Eyoeta. That's his name. He was the head of government business in the East. It was because of Nnamdi Azikiwe that he was sent back to Calabar. And from that day till now, the ethics have not forgiven us. This same useless Azikiwe. Let's hear him more.
Feeling which is widespread, but all are now determined to turn a new leaf and help repair the damage we have inflicted on ourselves.
This man is saying that we inflicted the damage on ourselves. Our people were being killed in the north. The Fulanis came to our land to kill us, and after losing nearly 3 million people, this is what has equated. We brought it on ourselves. Can you believe such nonsense? Can you believe such nonsense coming from the lips of Azikiwe? Can you believe such utter garbage coming from the lips of this idiot? This idiot called Azikiwe. And anybody from today onwards, I assure you, anybody who comes out in public to eulogize Dr. Azikiwe, IPOB will go after that very person. I assure you, I swear it. Let's hear what the Fulefu has to say.
Not only that, there is now a deep-seated desire to have effective central government which will hold the federation intact so that in the future no component of it shall be in position to challenge the fatherland.
Have you heard it now? This is what this man said.
That an enterprising people like the Igbo have been tongue-tied and emasculated. That they have allowed tyrants to blindfold and hoodwink them.
He is calling, you know, he say, you see all the language the Fulefu use. Nnamdi Kanu is hoodwinking you people. You are blindfolded. This, they got it from Azikiwe. Azikiwe is saying this thing about Ojukwu, that Ojukwu hoodwinked our people. Ojukwu, the people's general, fighting to save his people from extinction. This is what Azikiwe has to say about him. Or had to say about him. Can you believe that? Can anyone in their right mind believe this nonsense? Do you see what we're encountering at the hands of these Efulefus? Can you see how terrible that they have become? Anybody eulogizing or praising Azikiwe is a compound fool. A fool forever and ever. I will never be forgiven. I assure you, we'll never ever be forgiven. They thought this type of things would not come to light, but it has come to light. This is the, you are hearing the voice of Azikiwe. The same way that I played with the voice of Ahmadu Bello is how you are hearing the voice of Azikiwe. This is Nnamdi Azikiwe calling Ojukwu a rebel, calling Ojukwu a bandit, saying that we brought the destruction upon ourselves because he has been conquered by the same Fulani mentality. Fulani got to him, they conquered him. That was why he remained a fool until his death. A complete fool. A complete idiot. He is. Azikiwe back walk in hell.
So that in a war alleged to be fought for their survival.
He is saying that we are alleging. You see where they got their alleged nonsense from. In a war that they allege that they are fighting for their survival. Hey, Chineke Bokamukokebon. I'm telling you, this man, his head should be dug from the grave and burned. I said this thing in 2009, 2012, people castigated me. They did not understand what we were going through. They did not understand because they are ahistorical. They don't know anything. This is Dr. Nnamdi Azikiwe uttering garbage in London. Shell gave him money. That is why they cannot believe that Nnamdi Kanu will resist every advancement, every overture, every attempt at bribery. Because I said no, I'll continue to say no until Biafra is restored upon the face of this very earth. We are not like them. We can never be like them. Because we are chosen for this very noble work. Chosen by Elohim to do the work that heaven commanded must be done by the sons of men on this very earth. Azikiwe is calling Ojukwu a rebel. Azikiwe is calling Ojukwu if basically blaming us. Fulani people are killing us. Do you see where the Fule fools? That is why when they kill IPOB family members, when they slaughter us, you have the same Fule fool from this line, from this breed, the same rubbish. You brought it on yourself. Why must you march? Why must you gather? Why must you assemble? The same idiots. You see where they got it from? You see where all they got his nonsense from? We hold them responsible. Now you understand. When I go hard against some of the Fule Fule politicians, now you understand the reason why. I know them. I see them from a million miles. I've been preaching against this man, this Dr. Azikiwe, from the beginning. People didn't understand how evil this man was because he gave your father scholarship. When Awolowo was busy, not even scholarship, to one or two people, Awolowo was busy spreading scholarship everywhere in the West. Zeke was busy selecting a few people. Those who be loyal to him. What utter garbage. What utter garbage. This is Azikiwe. Now you see where your problems started from. From this idiot. That is where the genesis. That is why Allen Onyema, all these idiots shouting one Nigeria. You can see them from the mold. You can see them from the mold of Azikiwe. You can see them if in a straight line. I can name all of them for you. Ndibaliba. Useless set of people. Unbelievable. He said he has a PhD. 7 rubbish. A village bricklayer is more intelligent than Dr. Azikiwe. Very, very useless. They say, you don't respect. How can you? Look, can you compare what Azikiwe is saying with what the Sagwana is saying? I will defend my people. I will die for them. I will not give job to any woman. Look at what this idiot is saying. Fulani came to kill us. And this is what Azikiwe is saying. I don't know who did this to our people. But anyway, thank God for IPOB, the greatest family on this very earth. Without IPOB, by now, I think some of you will be giving birth to children called Amina or Dalhati. I'm telling you the truth. You people should thank. Any day you wake up, you thank IPOB. I'm telling you the truth. Unbelievable. You've heard from him. You will see these retards every day, parading their naturally endowed ignorance on the pages of newspapers or as guest panelists on channels television. They are as daft as a Fulani lawmaker in the Senate. You know that the daftest of all, a Fulani lawmaker in the Senate is the most useless you can get them. They don't come more useless than that. Even in the zoo, their youths are worse. Place them on a stipend of maybe 2 gigabytes of data and a second-hand Chinese phone, and they will deploy it to gossip. And once they do that, you have made their day. Is it their self-important politicians or elders? They don't even understand the extent to which Dr. Nnamdi Azikiwe destroyed our people. He is complicit in the death of our people between 67 and 70. In 2009, I said that Nnamdi Azikiwe's head should be dug out and burnt. Today, I repeat the same thing. His grave should be dug out. his skull severed from the rest of his skeleton, and he should be burnt in public. Because that man is evil. Many were led to believe that Azikiwe is one of the greatest Igbo men alive, but in reality, he was the problem of our people. We are still suffering today because of his antecedents. Do you know that Dr. Azikiwe appealed to the French government to stop sending aid to Biafra, referring to us as rebels? He was upset with the images of skeletal children on the pages of newspapers all over the world. He asked the French to stop sending aid to Biafra. And he's a great Igbo man. Chineke Bonok, all of you that celebrate Zeke, God will, all of you will suffer. All of you will suffer. All of you will suffer, I assure you. All of you will suffer. There were press, even a white woman realized that Dr. Azikiwe took money from Shell BP. I don't know what is wrong with our people. Anybody you give money to, they forget their principle. And I thought it's more or less a recent phenomenon. I don't know, it's been existing from time. Shell killing us. The same Shell went to Juku in Enugu, and Juku said no, that the oil belongs to the people, and they left to go and support the Fulanis to come and kill us. You went behind our backs, you went to London and you took money. The same thing is happening today in this struggle. The same way Ojukwu was demonized is how some people are demonizing the leadership of IPOB. The same people working for Fulani, it has now been proven. Before now, people thought that the criticism of Ojukwu by Azikiwe was well founded. But you can see it's because Shell gave him money. And I'm sure Amaka is putting up all those pictures with the placards and the posters. Very sad indeed. I have the transcript, and I think it will be published. The transcript of what Zeke actually said. After everything he did, no wonder another Ifulefu, Willie Obiano, declared a public holiday for him. You know, birds of the same feather. And they flock together. See how useless they are? That drunkard declared public holiday for Azikiwe that put us in the mess we are in today. That tells you all you need to know. Only Professor Chinua Achebe, I'm telling you, anywhere he is, may his soul continue to rest in peace. The greatest mistake this generation will make will be to trust all these Efulefus, all of them, as you see them in the government, because they're handpicked. If you're not a loyal Fulani servant, they will never ever rig you into power. It's not possible, it's not done anywhere. They will never rig you into power unless you are a loyal Fulani servant. Let me now give you the names of our genuine frontline leaders in Biafra land. Genuine frontline leaders in Biafra land. One is Mazin Bono Ojike. Write it down. People talk about leaders. I'm giving you the names of our leaders. Mazin Bono Ojike, Dr. Michael Okpara, Brigadier Timothy Onwuatuegwu, Colonel Joe Achuzie, the great Hannibal, Dean Chukwuemeka Odumegwu Ojukwu, the greatest of them all. The greatest of them all. The greatest is Ojukwu, the number one of them all. Philip Effiong, Dr. Kanu Ibiam, Professor Eninjoku, and Sam Mbakwe. The rest are basically chaff. These are your leaders. How do you know an Efulefu when you see them? As somebody who quite rightly argued, even if you slap an Efulefu or come and replace him with his northern, so-called northern brother, they will still tell he's not tribal.